is one of sin. And from that condition, all we do is sin. Hey man, what's your name? What's your name?
God.
Your name is God? Well, your parents are strange. Huh?
What do you know about Jesus?
What do I know about Jesus?
Yeah, you know
I know he is
him?
The eternal Son of God.
Is that right? And what
it
else
is.
You know?
I know that he, 2,000 years ago, was born of the Virgin Mary. So,
what
God,
do you, what you need to know. What you need to know. Don't touch me. I don't want to touch your mic, but don't
okay.
touch
cool.
me. Don't ever touch me, because I was going to touch the mic.
Well, you just touched the mic.
And we're talking about God.
Okay.
So, how are you going to be offensive when we're talking about God?
Well, because you went to grab my stuff.
I was going to tell you the most important thing to know about Jesus, right? Is grace.
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 Tell me about grace.
If you don't know grace,
you
don't know
anything. You need to take a walk.
Hey, you can.
That's the only way I want to.
I thought you were talking about grace.
I don't have anything else to say.
Okay, don't say nothing.
All right. What do you know about grace?
Right here, because you said leave. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to tell you something. You sitting up here preaching to these people, right?
Uh-huh.
About sin.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And all that, right?
Yeah.
You don't even know the first thing about grace.
Well, what does sin have to do with grace?
Because without grace, you ain't nothing. None of y'all.
What's grace without sin?
Nah, because see, Jesus taught me. Because see, I got a bullet in me. See, he gave me life 3 times. What did he do for you? Why are you touching on me? Don't ever touch me again.
I touch anything.
Okay.
It's ridiculous to try to host a conversation that's completely one-sided while blasting it off in the speaker to everyone in the vicinity.
So
I don't want to hear this
nonsense. I'm primarily here to preach. I'm not here to have a conversation.
Have a conversation is nonsense.
I'm here to preach, though.
Okay, go ahead and preach.
So sometimes people pause and they have a question.
Okay, that's
and
great.
Then when they say something good and worthwhile, I repeat it into the mic. Because God is good, he's a good judge, he does not let sin go unpunished. In fact, he refuses to let sin go unpunished. So Jack, I bet because you're tough, you can process pain by putting your head down and knowing you can just drive through it, knowing there's going to be an end. There's an end date to your pain, right? Now, none of us have that. None of us have that to persevere through hell, right? So you can't go to hell and say, okay, I'm just going to put my head down and grind, right? Because eventually it's going to be over. That doesn't exist. Once you go to hell, you're just there. So you could be there a million years under the torment and wrath of God, but after a million years, you're no closer to the end. You're no closer to the end. That's what's so terrible about it. That's what's so terrible about it.
Put some music on, please, sir.
I didn't know you had that
this
persuasion.
This is some nonsense.
So,
yes, I do. I do have that persuasion.
Oh, so there you
go. I got
go.
The persuasion of love and kindness
nice.
For everything in the world.
Now, that's the terribleness of hell. And so now we realize that our need is salvation from God and his wrath because of our sin. That's what we need. Now, as I said at the beginning,
I don't want to hear it. I'm trying to escape.
Command
and
is
I gotta listen to this bullshit.
And believe the gospel.
Please turn it down.
And you will be saved.
I've been sitting over there for 30 minutes trying to escape.
Believe the gospel.
And I gotta listen to this shit.
And you will be saved. So the you will be saved is not just a need.
I love
but a
God.
Promise.
I love
the
God.
Of what you
I
can
just
have.
Don't need to
and
come
here's
in
the thing.
Public and hear this,
this
shit.
This is what you need. And as
turn
I'm here to tell you, you can
please.
Have it.
Or dance
now, you
with
can
me.
Have it.
Dance with me,
salvation is. You can, instead of getting what you deserve, instead of getting hell, instead of getting the wrath of God, you can get salvation. You can go from an enemy of God to becoming a friend of God. You can be reconciled to the living God. You can go from being at enmity with him to being in right relationship with him. That's the nature of salvation. You can go from not knowing God as anything but your yes, your creator, but unfortunately for you, then the one against whom you've sinned, and so your enemy. You can come to know him as your father. You can come to know him as your provider. You can come to know him as your savior. You can walk with him day in and day out, reconciled to him, at peace with him. I'm not going to shake your hand. if you come in polite next time, I'll shake your hand. I reserve my hand for people that are polite. So if you act like a man and not like a child, I'll shake your hand.
Yeah, is that God's love being shown to somebody?
I shook your hand.
Out of here.
Hey!
Yeah, you can't. I won't respond. So, we can have this salvation. Now, we can only have it God's way. We need it from God because of our sin against God, and we can have salvation only God's way. This is God's way. Repent and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Critical to having salvation is rightly understanding who the Lord Jesus Christ is. Now, I told you at the beginning that He is the Lord. He's the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and that makes Him not just King over there, but King here. He is the King here over the 92107. There's no square inch of the universe over which He does not declare His Lordship, as one theologian in the past said. He's the King everywhere. And the Lord Jesus Christ is no mere human king, right? Many kings have come, many kings are, many kings will be. But you know, if I asked you, hey, who was the 8th emperor of Rome, the greatest empire in the world? None of us know, because when kings die, they're dead. And after a little bit of death, they're forgotten. Take all the great men of the world, and they're dead and buried and gone. But Jesus is not like that, and that's because Jesus is no mere man. Jesus is the eternal Son of God. Jesus is actually He who made you and me and everyone and everything. The Son is the Word of God through which all was made. There is nothing that is made that was not made through Jesus the Son. And 2,000 years ago, the eternal Son of God became a man, all according to the plan and purpose of God. Oh, what's up? What's up, skater? So, 2,000 years ago, the eternal Son of God became a man. He took on human flesh, adding to Himself full humanity. So, fully God, not ceasing to be God, Jesus became a man. And, hey, what's up? I remember a great conversation with the two of you. It's good to see you again. What's up?